point. Our next guest, David Yamani, joins us. He's a professor of sociology at Wake Forest University in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. And he has a new book out, which is very cool, Concealed Carry Revolution, Expanding the Right to Bear Arms in America. David Yamani joins us right now. David, thank you for being here, man.
Tom, it's an honor to be on your show.
Well, I appreciate it. I've been going through your book here. And for those who would be interested, it's a very small book, very easy to go through. Kind of give them the overview. What's it about? And I guess the real question is, why'd you do this?
Yeah. Well, I'm not a historian or a legal scholar, but I've been trying to understand American gun culture for the last decade or so. And one of the things I really wanted to do was to have a sort of interesting and reliable history of the development of America's concealed carry laws and where they stand today. And there's just nothing really out there. I mean, there's a lot of long books. There's a lot of things buried in, you know, little libraries here and there. And so, you know, I thought one thing I could do as an appetizer for my bigger book that I'm working on is to just put out a short, concise, reliable overview of America's concealed carry laws. And I think the general trend, as many people know, has been towards a liberalization of those laws so mm-hmm. that, you know, as we sit here today, it's so much easier for an average citizen to legally carry a concealed weapon in public than it was in the 19th century.
Well, it's interesting. You say in here, the 19th century was the century of concealed weapons prohibitions. The 20th century was the century of concealed weapons permits, with may-issue permit systems dominating early and then giving way to the shall-issue later. And then, of course, I'm looking at it and thinking, and so will the 21st century be a time of constitutional or permitless carry?
Well, definitely. You know, we have, I submitted the manuscript to the publisher in December, and already since that time, I need to put out a second edition because five more states have gone permitless. And if we count Vermont, we're going to have, with Texas, more states that are permitless carry than are shall issue. And taken together, you know, that's 41 out of 50 states. So this is definitely the dominant trend. And I think, you know, with the Corlett case pending in the Supreme Court, we, you know, may see those may issue states being forced more into a shall issue position. So the liberalization, I think, is ongoing.
One of the things that, and I've been doing this show for 26 years, been writing about guns and gun rights for 50 years, as I've reported on and watched the movement in the concealed carry movement, when Florida being probably the first most recognized state to start with concealed carry permits and moving across the country, it was like the same story, the same fight, same arguments being heard every time, with the anti saying, well, you know, this will result in blood in the street, yada, yada, yada. And us saying, no, it won't. And even after we had 10 states and 20 states and 30 states that had done it without any ill effects, they were still using the same arguments. What's
with that? Yeah, certainly. And, you know, I think we see that same thing as shall issue states go permitless, or even states that haven't gone permitless as they scale back their training requirements, as Ohio did and as South Carolina did, you know, that there is this constant fear that the blood will be running in the streets as legal concealed carriers take advantage of that right. And yet I know of no data, and I tried to keep up with that research as much as I can, but I know of no data that shows that states that are permitless have any more problems with people carrying concealed than states that are shall issue, or that shall issue states have more problems than may issue states. You know, every once in a while we'll hear of, you know, some knucklehead doing something stupid and they happen to be carrying a concealed weapon. But the fact that those things become news are suggestive of how rare they are, in fact. And, you know, most people who are legally carrying concealed weapons are doing so perfectly within the bounds of the law and also of ethics, I think.
Do you have an idea? I don't even know. I've lost track of what the number is. How many people in the U.S. have permits for concealed carry now?
Yeah, I think the last report that John Law put out, which are the best numbers out there, said around 20 million. You know, the number increases every year, but, you know, at the same time, if it weren't for permitless carry, that it may increase even more. So mm-hmm. I always say that there are at least 20 million people who are legally carrying concealed weapons, plus however many people are doing so in the permitless states.
Well, not only that, when I think about it, if you include the permitless states, you could possibly have 50 or 100 million people who can legally carry a concealed loaded firearm without a permit. I mean, the number would be the total population of all the permitless states, or at least adult population.
Yeah, without question. I think that, you know, I use the term that a friend of mine gave me for as Alaska carry for permitless carry other than Vermont, because in all those states you do have the option to get a concealed carry permit, even though you're not required to have one. And I think there's some good incentives to do so, like reciprocity with other states.
Right.
As well as, you know, some states allow you to carry in more places if you do have a permit. And so I think permits may never go away, and I don't see permitless carry sort of removing some of those incentives. You know, we're a long way from concealed carry reciprocity, I'm afraid, but
right.
You know, that would certainly make the permitting system more attractive.
Well, for people who are interested in this, it's called The Concealed Carry Revolution by David Yamani. How can people get a copy of this?
Well, it's on Amazon right now as a printed copy. I've been struggling a little with the publisher to get the Kindle version out there because I know a lot of people prefer that. So, you know, that printed copy through Amazon. I also have this thing called Buy Me a Coffee, which is similar to Patreon.
Okay.
And if people support me there, they can either get a printed signed copy or they can pick up an electronic copy that I'm giving to people who support me there.
And they can find, just look for David Yamani, Y-A-M-A-N-E. Before I let you go, you mentioned a bigger or larger book. What is that?
Well, that's my Gun Culture 2.0 book, the term I stole from Michael Bain, and that's going to be the bigger story of the shift in the American gun culture towards self-defense and my own involvement in that. So I'm working on finding a publisher for that this year and maybe out next year if I can find the time to do it.
There you go. People can follow gunculture2.0.com, guncurious.com, and on Twitter at gunculture2.pt0, and they can find you there.
Absolutely.
Hey, thank you so much, man.
I appreciate it. It's good to
Alrighty.
Talk to you.
Absolutely. You take care. Thanks for what you're doing there. All right, quick break.